Hi everybody and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be tackling something that's slightly different for me. I've never actually tackled a night scene, so this is something completely new. The picture is by thanks to Steven Cronin. He posted it on his Patreon site and basically threw the gauntlet down for people to have a go at it and see what they made of it. It's a nighttime scene in St Ives. This involves perspective, negative painting, obviously high contrast with light and dark, shadows, and a very limited palette. So we'll see how we go. I hope you enjoy the ride. So on with the video. Okay, first job is to mask out the highlights on this. It's mainly the railings. There's a strip of light across the railings, picking up from this source here, which is a bright light on the side of the building. So that is going to be the main focus of masking fluid, and then just picking out the highlights and just on the edges of people as well. Obviously they're picking up some bright light. There's a bit down there, the water, from a window that's actually in there, and that's about it. So we'll proceed with the masking fluid now. I'm going to be using a ruling pen for this, which is quite fine, and I'll be using a ruler as well to keep these railings straight. I'll start from up here and work downwards, so that I don't get in my own way. So I think I'm just going to dampen just slightly around this area here, so that when I put the masking fluid in, it will actually leave a feathered edge rather than a hard edge around this light. That's the plan anyway. So you need to actually wet a larger area than what you're actually going to mask, because you don't want it running up to a hard edge, because you'll just end up exactly where you started. Right, okay. Let's put this in here. And you see how that's bleeding into that? That should give us a nice soft focus. For that light. Okay. Right, that's around the light there. I'll just put a little bit more on the building as well, just down here. Okay. Right. Put a spot on the water. Just here. There's a reflection in the water there. Just from this. There's a lit window there that just sort of comes down the water a bit. Right, one or two spots around, just dotted in the background, of just lights in distant houses. Just a random. I'll put them on there. Okay. That's it with the brush. Let's go for the rolling pin now. Let's just come down, just soften that up a bit there. Okay. Let's go with the rolling pin. And as I say, I've got to use a ruler for this, just to get these edges straight. Apologies if my head's in the way. Just I'm holding the ruler just with my fingers under the edge there. Just so that I'm just going to run this rolling pin just down the edge. There we go. There's a couple across here. That'll do on that. Okay. I'm going for a finer brush now. Just to do one or two around the tops of these posts. Just round here. Where these posts are just catching the light. Come down the edge of this post as well. I can always paint it, as long as I've got a bright edge, I can always darken any other edge there. Don't use your best brushes for masking fluid. I think I said it before, but masking fluid will ruin brushes. Another trick is to actually rub them on soap before you actually dip it into the masking fluid. But these are proper masking fluid brushes. And providing you don't let it dry in there, they should rinse out fairly fine. Oops, that's blobbed a bit there. And when that's dried off, I'll rub that out, just take that edge off that. Okay. I'm just going to use a nib just to go around the edge of these people. Just on the tops of the heads there. And shoulders. Gives us a few highlights. That's probably enough. I'll let that dry now and then we'll carry on with the painting. It'd be more a case of working from dark to light actually, rather than the other way around, as it normally is with watercolour, light to dark. I'll start with a fairly lightest wash in this area, but I will obviously quickly progress to the darker areas around here. So let's mix some colours. It's got a slightly reddish tint to it, so let's just get a mop brush out. Don't want too much water. So we'll do some red, quite a thickish red. Okay, we'll come down here, take some of that red. I'm going to use natural tint to actually darken this down as well. So we'll put some neutral tint in that. Not too much water because I want it fairly dense colour wise, but I'll put a touch of red in that just to give us the right consistency there. Okay, and do a slightly pinkish wash as well. Have some touch of rose madder. Let's have a look, see how that looks. Yeah, I think that needs a slight touch of red in it as well, just to take the purpliness off it. Okay, just going to dampen in here slightly. And just down the seawall on that. Don't want it too damp though. So that's going to be dark across there. Okay, give that a second or two. We'll make a start with, I think, this reddish colour up here. Right, it's casting down on this bit around this. Fairly lightish there. That's going to be darker. Put a bit of dark down here now. I'm using Arch today. Arch paper, 140-pound knot. I've steered away from Bockingford because of the dark colours going in. Bockingford is so easy to lift off that it will cause problems basically with the washes intermingling when I start putting other stuff on the top. But try and get that smooth transition there. Okay, a bit more dark to go over that, darken it up in that corner with a bit of this as well. That's a bit of neutral tint and light red. Is up this corner here. Let's come down into the water here now. Some horizontal strokes in there just to the impression of the water. Okay. Going darker again just the other side of the rails here. There's one or two bits shining through in the paper, sparkle on the water. Going dark there. Let's get some more neutral tint in that bit. Very dark down this corner again. Pick out one or two bits in the water there. Problem with any dark colour, it just lifts so easily. That you end up pulling off the first wash. I'm going to reach a point where I'm going to have to let it dry, I think. This is quite intense here, so let's put some more red in that. I'll just speed up this section while I'm painting the seawall there. Just a few directional brush strokes, just adds a little bit of perspective to that quayside there. Helps to lead you into the picture as well. is lightened down here. A little bit of a glaze on the water there. Right. Go back to the neutral tint. Intensify this top corner again. An alternative to this black, putting this neutral tint actually on here in several coats, would have been possibly to use something like Indian ink. Indian ink has been used by other artists like Rowland Hilder in the past, but I decided to go with the neutral tint. And it's working quite well. I'm quite happy with it so far. It's not a typical watercolour anyway. I mean, there's a little bit of transparency going on in the centre, but for the main part it's quite dark and opaque. That's quite good now. Actually, I'm quite happy with that. Let's intensify this quayside. So this top corner needs a bit more on it. Clean my brush off. Ease that down into that. Go for a slightly smaller brush now, I think, just to put some detailed edges around these people on the edge of this building. Okay, soften the edge here to the water. Improve that edge there.
touch of touch more pink into that one. Right, I think I'll leave it at that and let it dry and then add some more bits afterwards. Right, I've dried that out. I'll run the hairdryer over it. I've just got a little bit of a edge there that I'll run some thicker paint over, and that, according to the picture, is slightly red. Quite a darkish red, so we'll going with some light red. Trying to follow the perspective of the key as well. Okay, let's just dampen my brush, clean it off. Let's just come back this way. It's a tad just to give me a soft line there. Okay, that's better. A touch more red in here as well. Just soften that off. This is the shoe. Okay. These figures. time to remove the masking fluid. Just need to add a few dark details to these railings now. I'll be leaving a light edge, obviously showing that the light's just shining on the top of it. Just toning down those distant lights there. That's just touching up the water there. Putting some detail into it. That's the reflection from those distance lights. Just checking to see if that's actually dry. That's made a bit of a mess there actually in the centre. That masking fluid didn't work as well as I'd hoped. It tended to sort of creep through it, so I'm going to recover that with painting the light in with white gouache towards the end. I'm just painting the railings in now. It's worked well on that, just leaving the light edge on the top edge. It's obviously the light coming from the light source on the building there.
just a few final touches to these figures. Okay, we'll start on the gouache now. Yeah, that looks as if it's dry enough now. I'll just touch it up with the hairdryer and in with the gouache. Thank you. just brightening up the edge of the building there from this lamp. A lot of people frown on using white gouache, but in certain circumstances it's ideal to use it just to recover your highlights. I certainly have no qualms in actually using it. On a final note, if you've got any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments area below and I'll be happy to respond to anything you wish to discuss or point out. Well, that's pretty much it. I do hope you enjoyed it. Just do the final reveal now.
Okay, here's the reveal.
Just take the frame off.
Oh, I'm quite pleased with that. That's the first time I've ever had a go at a night scene.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please give it a thumbs up if you have. Give it a thumbs down if you haven't. And please consider subscribing to my channel. And I'll catch you on the next video. Bye for now.